Hi, before we are going to go to asymptotic analysis, we going to start counting operation in our program or our algorithm. Okay, we going to estimate time by counting number of operation in our algorithm. We going to assume that one command or one programming statement take a fixed amount of time. And then if we have 1,000 of them, it's going to have 1,000 of time longer, something like that. And for simplicity, we're going to assume that any statement going to take the same amount of time. Set as x equal to t or x math.abs negative 178 are considered to have the same amount of time. It's not be true, but it's good enough for our purpose. And note that we have in n equal to n divided by 2. This, I'm going to count it as three operations, right? We have declaration, we have assignment, and then we have division. Okay, now let's start counting. Remember code from last time, we have each farm 0, each farm 1, and each farm 2. We're going to count each farm 0 to the worst case. It means that we're going to return here, not over there, not and on the top. We're going to return on the bottom. So this one is one operation, compiling operation. This one is another one. This one is three, as I said, right? Okay, in the loop, this one going to perform only once, right? So this is two operation, these two, and these two are depending on number of repetition. This I plus plus is going to be the same as number of operation. Why this m minus one? Oh no, sorry. Why this I less than equal to m going to be one more than the number of repetition? So number of repetition from two to m is m minus 1, this is number of repetition of I plus plus. And this one is 1 greater, so this one is m. Together is 2m plus 1. And these are two operations within the loop. So the loop is m minus 1 repetition is 2 times m minus 1. And this one return 2 is another one, right? So all together we have 4m plus 5. And we change it back to n. It's going to be 2n plus 5 because m is n divided by 2. Okay, let's count each prime one. Each prime one is going to be the same, right? 1, 1. And then this one is changing from n over 2 to mat dot square root n. And we change it to int. And then we put it to m and we declare m. So this is 4. There are 4 operations. And this one, the rest are the same. So we count all this as 2m plus 6, because this one is another one, right? This is plus 5 and this is plus 6. Okay. It's prime 2. This one is a little bit complicated. So this one is 1, 1. This one is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this one is 4. And this loop going to repeat m divided by 6 times. Now, strictly speaking, it's going to be m divided by 5. Sorry, m minus 5 divided by 6. But I'm too lazy to do that. So I'm going to count it as m divided by 6. That's all. And then this one is one more, right? And then this is two more. And then this two operation time number of repetition, and this is three operation time number of repetition. So this all together going to be 7 times m divided by 6 plus 15. So this back change to n, so 7 square root n over 6 plus 15. So all together we have this t function from each time 0, each time 1, and each time 2. Let's plot some graph. Now for small input in less than 20, I already said in last video that these are not different from each other. You can use, you can pick anyone and use in your program. It's going to be fine. It only take like few tens for less than 100 millisecond. It one less than 1/10 of a second, right? Now, if you go from 0 to a million, it's going to make a difference, right? So it's going to be like really, really small for each farm 1 and 2. It blend together again. And then it's going to be very large for each farm 0. Okay. Let's not care about each farm 0. Let's plot each farm 1. This one is each farm 1. Actually, it should be smooth, but I use zero and then 5,000, so it's not smooth. But anyway, this one go together even to a million. But actually, it's going to go together no matter how large the input is, right? So let's discuss this. Each palm zero are grow at the same rate at input. Input go to a million, this going to go to a million because it is a linear function. Each palm 1 and 2 go proportional to each other and proportion to square root of the input, right? Each palm 1 and 2 are comparable, right, to each other. You can see, you can look at the function. Okay. It's typically possible to count number of operation, and I will have you count number of operation in algorithm in this class. And it also applicable to counting space. So while actual time depends on machine, number of operation doesn't. So this one is good for directly compare algorithm to algorithm without implementing it or running it on a machine, right? We are not going to compare machine, we comparing algorithm. And rather than remember this function of all the algorithm, we're going to compare this to a known function by using asymptotic analysis. Okay. So in summary, rather than measuring time, we count number of operation in algorithms. Number of operation are just the estimated number of operation. We are not going to count it exactly, but it is good enough for our purpose. And we are, if we know the number at the function of operation, we can compare algorithm easily, right? And however, if we have to memorize all the function, it's going to be a lot. It's not going to be possible. So we're going to compare, we're going to count it, make a function and then compare it to a well-known function, simple function, by using asymptotic analysis. Okay, that is all for this video. Happy computing.